A security analyst, meanwhile, says this isn't the first time China used cyanide in Philippine waters. Chester Cabalza says Beijing also used the same tactic around Mischief Reef, Iroquois Reef, and other areas China wants to militarize. Cabalza also points out cyanide use is not only a form of illegal fishing, it's also considered chemical warfare.
If you look at the size of Bajo del Masinloc, it is as large as the size of Quezon City. If you destroy all the marine life there, including the corals, then definitely there would be a problem there. Hopefully, this will not escalate, especially that Bajo del Masinloc is still a prime property of the Philippines. What China is doing right now is a form of illegal activity that would destroy not only our marine resources, but also it destroys also the relations.
China accused of using cyanide to prevent Filipinos from fishing in Bajo del Masinloc. We have this report.
Chinese fisherfolk have been engaged in cyanide fishing in Bajo del Masinloc, destroying parts of one of the traditional fishing grounds of Filipinos. This is what the Bureau of Fisheries and Aquatic Resources told reporters, saying they received information from Filipino fisherfolks that parts of the traditional fishing grounds, including corals, have been destroyed due to the poisonous substance.
According to Filipino fishermen, yung mga Chinese fishermen, if I'm not mistaken, ay gumagamit po ng cyanide as well as yung mga Vietnamese fishers. And according to the statement of our Filipino fishers, they intentionally destroyed Bajo del Masinloc to prevent Filipino fishing boats to fish in the area. So again, these are serious concern that we really need to condemn on the part of the BFAR.
The BFAR has yet to release the extent of damage in the Bajo del Masinloc due to China's alleged use of cyanide in the area. But officials estimate the cost to breach the billion peso mark.
China being, if I'm not mistaken, being a signatory to the UNCLOS, so they're committing a violation because, IUU fishing undermines the sustainability of our water, not only of our waters, but the waters of the whole world.
Data from the BFAR show that there are around 385,300 Filipino fisher folk who depend on the West Philippine Sea for their livelihood. They catch some 275,520 metric tons of fish annually, which is equivalent to 6 to 7% of the country's entire fisheries sector. The Department of Justice earlier said the Philippines is looking to haul China before another international court, this time over their illegal activities that have damaged marine and environmental resources within the Philippines' exclusive economic zone. But while that has yet to happen, the BFAR has allocated 660 million pesos to purchase and distribute larger fishing vessels to boost the capacity of local fisher folk. Of the 66 units of 62-footer vessels the country will purchase this year, at least 10 are expected to be distributed to fishing cooperatives in the West Philippine Sea.
We are now into the direction of actually capacitating also our Filipino fisher folks with bigger boats. Kung mas maraming supply ang maibababa natin sa ating mga pamilihan, napaka-posible po na mas bababa pa ang presyo ng isda sa ating mga palengke.
Meantime, the Philippine Coast Guard also slammed China's alleged use of cyanide in waters near Bajo del Masinloc.
The destruction of the marine environment is not just an attack to one country's sovereignty.
Yes.
This is actually a crime against humanity. It's not just the Philippines who is going to be affected kapag persistently and constantly they're going to do this. Hindi lang tayo ang tinitira dito. Ang naapektuhan dito ay ang buong mundo.
Aside from the alleged use of cyanide fishing, the PCG says Chinese officials have also installed floating barriers around the area last February 15. For now, Tariela declined to disclose details as to how the government will respond against the illegal barriers China placed, well, within the Philippines' exclusive economic zone. Katrina Domingo, ABS-CBN News.
A House lawmaker wants government to revoke all permits approved for the Masungit-Jia Reserve in Rizal. House Deputy Minority Leader Franz Castro made that plea following drilling activities conducted there by the Rizal Wind Energy Corporation. Its mother company, Singapore-based Vina Energy, said it has since ceased all its activities there. The company notes it had all the necessary permits for the study on the potential of wind energy. But Castro insists preserving natural heritage and biodiversity should be prioritized over industrial interests that could irreversibly damage the ecosystem. Castro now calling for a congressional probe into the matter. One of the proponents for a people's initiative to amend the Philippine Constitution hits calls to junk signature forms for the campaign. See, over the weekend, Senator Aimee Marcos urged the poll body to just discard documents for the people's initiative instead of issuing forms for those who want to withdraw their support. But former lawmaker Alfredo Garben Jr. says such a move would be very undemocratic.
Millions of Filipinos signified and signed to the People's Initiative. Alam nyo ho, ang parte ng isang demokratikong proseso ay yung pagkukumbinse at meron din na proseso para mag-withdraw doon sa pinirmahan nila. Yung one-liner proposed amendment sa ating saligang batas, ito ay napaliwanag sa ating mga kababayan sa barangay level, walang technicality, hindi sila nahirapan sa pag-intindi ng joint voting.
Garbin also accusing the Senate of weaponizing charter change discussions.
Ang taong bayan na nagsasabi na dapat joint voting instead of separate voting dahil ito nga yung nagiging balakid to effect the needed change in our constitution. And this has always been the deadlock, and sometimes the Senate weaponize the ambiguity or infirmity so as not to proceed with any constitutional amendment.
6 out of 10 Filipinos backing calls for the Philippines to rejoin the International Criminal Court. A recent survey by Okta Research shows 55% of Filipinos also want government to cooperate with the ICC's probe into the Duterte administration's bloody drug war. The findings of the Okta survey match the recent poll conducted by social weather stations, which revealed a growing number of Filipinos supporting the ICC's intervention.
Sa Balas Luzon, 65% ang yes and 35% ang no. Pero pagdating natin sa Mindanao, 42% lang ang yes at 58% ang no. So may regional disparity sa mga sagot. Ibig sabihin, by region, medyo iba yung preference ng mga tao. Sa Davao region, 6% lang nagsabi na yes, na we should cooperate. At 94% nagsabi no. So almost halos lahat sabi huwag mag-cooperate. Pero pag titingnan natin yung mga iba-ibang regions, karamihan majority ng Pilipino, scientific naman itong survey, yun nga bahagi ng scientific survey sa amin. At yan yung pulso ng mga Pilipino. Pinag-usapan pa lang natin dito, and let's be clear, is the investigation. Wala pa naman yung resolution or kung ano yung mangyayari. So I think may impression ako na yung mga Filipinos are for the process and they support the judicial process, kumbaga.
Former President Rodrigo Duterte pulled Manila out of the ICC's Rome Statute after the tribunal began a preliminary probe into his bloody anti-narcotics campaign. The Marcos administration, meanwhile, sees the ICC as a threat to Philippine sovereignty. The Senate issuing a subpoena for embattled televangelist Apollo Quiboloy. Senators want the Kingdom of Jesus Christ leader to appear at a public hearing to answer accusations of rape and forced labor within his ministry. Quiboloy had snubbed the previous hearing chaired by Senator Risa Ontiveros. The upper chamber resumed its inquiry today.
Hindi din po tayo papayag na sabihin sa mga victim survivor, teka muna, mayroon tayong krisis pampolitika. Wait lang tayo kasi tatapusin pa ang mga ibang issues. Hindi po ako papayag na ma-etche puera ang tapang at lakas ng loob na inipon ng mga victim survivors para lang unahin ang mga bangayan sa politika. Kaya nagpapasalamat ako, salamat kaayo sa Senate President for signing the subpoena against Apollo Quiboloy. My office has made it our policy to put the voices of women and children first, to put the voices of the victim survivors at the center. And I'm glad that our institution, under the current Senate leadership, has made it its policy too.
Quiboloy's lawyers have insisted on their client's innocence. Quiboloy is also wanted in the U.S. for alleged sex trafficking and bulk cash smuggling.